We're still looking at the parable of the sower, and we are looking at Matthew chapter 13, verse 5 and 6. Some fell on stony places where they did not have much earth, and they immediately sprang up because they had no depth of earth. But when the sun was up, they were scorched, and because they had no root, they withered away. Jesus spoke about the second kind of soil on which the seed fell, and he described it as stony or rocky. And it doesn't mean that the land was just rock. It means that there was soil, there was earth, but just underneath, just beneath it was rock. So when you see it, it will look like a very good soil, but underneath there is rock. And because of that, there is no depth of soil for the seed that falls on it. When the seed falls on it, it has enough to germinate. It has enough to spring up. It has enough to grow. But then, after some time, it can't grow again because it has no depth. It's not able to shoot its roots deep, and it doesn't survive. And Jesus talks about a couple of factors that affect this kind of plant in a rocky area. And the first one is the scorching sun. Usually the sun is a friend to plants. It helps in the process of photosynthesis. It helps the plants to make food and to grow stronger. And so in this parable, Jesus says that the sun represents trials and persecutions. And they're not there to destroy the plant or to destroy our lives. But if we have no depth, then what God has designed to mature us, to grow us, to make us better, may end up destroying us. Not because what comes our way is bad, but because we have no roots and we have no depth. And so the passage says that the stony soil has no depth. It is shallow. And it represents Christians who come to Christ. They hear his word, but they allow the word of God to only apply to a small area of their lives, a tiny area. It's like most of the people who follow Jesus. They followed him because of the miracles, of healings, of all the good things that were happening. But when Jesus wanted them to know him better, they didn't want to know him any better. They left. And there are people who come to God, they are happy for his promises, that he will heal them, they will prosper, they will do well. They expect God to bless them. But they don't apply the word of God to help them to have endurance, to have perseverance, to stand temptation, to stand trial. And when hardship comes, there's no depth in them. So the word of God must not just be applied to a small area of our lives. Don't just say, oh, I only believe God for salvation. Or I only believe God for healing. I only want God to prosper me. I only want God to do this and that for me. God wants to do more than that for you, and he wants his word to soak deep into our hearts, to get deep into our hearts, to be implanted in our hearts so that our whole life is ruled by the word of God. And when we do that, we grow roots. And when we have roots, we can now pick on the nutrients that God has given us in his word to make us flourish. So, if we don't want to be the stony-hearted person, then allow the word of God to break the stoniness of your heart, the stubbornness of your heart, and take deep roots in you so that nothing in life will shake you. No trial, no temptation, no stress, no persecution will shake you because you have roots and you have depth. Let us pray. Say with me, Heavenly Father, help me to have a deeper relationship with you. Plant your word deep in my heart. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Well, I'll be with you again tomorrow. I'm Pastor Mensah Otterbill. Shalom, peace, and life to you.